proceeded on leave today, would you have any money to survive on? Or would it now be time for you to think about how to make money? After blowing out on retirement, at 60, would you have secured your finances through savings or a pension scheme? My name is Nana Ekuya Mensah-Brampa, and in pensions, I meet some individuals on the brink struggling to get by after years of work. The stories, the experiences, and the reality. A pension is basically a long-term savings plan with tax relief. Getting tax relief on pensions means some of your money that would have gone to the government as tax goes into your pension instead. Ghana's pension system has seen an evolution with the transition into Basic Social Security Scheme in 1965 and the creation in 1972 of Segment Administrators, the Social Security and National Insurance Trust, SNIT. Ghana's public and private sector pension systems are integrated, with every Ghanaian citizen able to access a modern three-tier structure which is overseen by the National Pensions Regulatory Authority, NPRA, under the management of SNIT. The first tier is a compulsory pay-as-you-go scheme contributed to by formal sector workers, 13.5%. The contribution is managed by SNIT. The second tier is a defined contributory occupational pension scheme mandatory for workers, with 5% contribution made on behalf of members. This contribution is managed privately by approved trustees.
We felt that it would be good to separate the monthly pension from the tier two, which is the lump sum. And that will also give flexibility to the workers to decide themselves which fund manager they want to deal with. So we wanted the workers to have the freedom to choose, so that there is competition. Instead of everything being on SNIT, this worker will say, I'm going to Data Bank, somebody will go to Enterprise, and then they will see the return that they get from each of them. So that was the whole idea. And to make it the workers to have a hold on their tier two.
The third tier, which includes all provident funds and all other pension funds outside tiers 1 and 2, is a voluntary scheme.
But traditionally, people save towards their pension. As far as we are concerned, you know, when we say traditionally, people invest in their children. In other jurisdictions, parents don't depend on their children in their old age, because these are very former jurisdictions. They have good pensions and the rest, so they don't really rely on their children when they are old in order to make ends meet. But in Ghana, informally, in the traditional setup, people invest in other areas in such a way that when they grow old, they will be taken care of by their siblings, by their children, their grandchildren.
Meet 52-year-old Thomas Barr. He is a worker in active service in the formal sector with a baggage of loans. He started saving at age 51 and made attempts to save money whilst his employer paid his SNIT contributions. But his problems started when he took his first loan in his early 30s. This thirst for loans grew stronger and he began to take loans to pay off loans.
And that's what brought me down. A problem, loans upon loans. In fact, I go in for loan to pay school fees, loans to take care of health, loans. Even I'm going for loan to pay loans. So it's like every time in your life is loan. And there's this system they call additional loan. Overdraft. As for overdraft, you can't count. And then we're saving that Sawa Rural Bank in those days. And that's where I work first. So the problem of saving, I couldn't save. Couldn't save because I was told Senator Raguthen, and because of that, my mind was off. And not because Senator was not good. Me, myself, I didn't have the education to save for my future.
Like Thomas, there are lots of workers with similar challenges, torn between saving for the future, paying for loans, and securing pensions on retirement.
When you think about a retirement plan, you should be thinking about how much money do I need to live comfortably when I retire? What would I like to be doing when I retire? So you need to think about it in terms of the money you earn today. So if you use, let's say you're earning $3,000 today, a month, you need to ask yourself, will $3,000 be sufficient for me in retirement? Or can I live on less than $3,000? Your retirement plan is that document, for want of a better word, that kind of builds the picture of your retirement. And then you will take different steps to achieve it. But the plan is what you will follow until you get there. And even into retirement, you will follow that plan because you'll be there in retirement for possibly 20 or even 30 more years.
On retirement, experts say the ball game is different. Although the Social Security and National Insurance Trust scheme has been designed for every worker, only a little above 1.6 million, representing about 11% of workers in the country, are actively contributing.
Formed some 27 years ago, the National Pensioners Association has over 80,000 members, although not all formal sector workers who have retired are members of the association. It's not been all rosy for every member of the association, and the major challenge for most of these members is healthcare.
People are facing problems health-wise. Health-wise, people are suffering. We have buried some of our, most of our people, we buried them because of health-wise.
With over 200,000 pensioners in the country, not all fall under the association's umbrella. Members meet regularly to motivate each other. They contribute welfare and receive support when needed.
Pension. 55 years, they're from voluntary pension, and I'm called pension. My call pension is a car, it is a year. Can 4,250. Sika pension for the jam acquire. Now, the baby snit, now me join a snit. Snit between my car. There are 5 cities, 50 pesos. 5 cities, 50 pesos. And I did 2 America. But I was able to manage because my was gold face or no. Now my share say, a simi dying, kakra, 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 kakra. Till before I'm back up pension, no, my simi and kasa mi fee.
But there's still more.
I see if you share baby, I'm a qua, limited, better. Me try as me new baby, but long last no. Long God focus say, baby, I'm seeing you now. They say me, oh, me high dying. Think I'm me, my green saying, Kaja pension dear, me buffia, Nankaja cram me one, Ninkamedia, a pet baby, meda, sine bea, me who ain't trim. But you see, now me woman and cousin, me who trim to the same say, one. Bosom is 15th, near Triaka, ayahi. Until 15 free, until next month. Pension, heading, cause pension, yadi amboa. I just say, Ibia. I just say, Unquara, Ewu, baby, and sana, Odin Bay. Yes, I pass, say, Ibia, only be pa, obebre.
If I die, my wife should be paid. It's been done to the military, the police, and some other people. Why can't the SNIT also apply this to all pensioners? So that when the one dies, the wife or the husband may be paid till she also goes away, period. But when it doesn't happen, because a widow or a widower suffers a lot.
According to SNIT, about 230,000 people, representing 10% of Ghanaians above 60, receive the monthly SNIT pensions. The National Pensions Regulatory Authority, NPRA, is the regulator and monitor of all three-tier pension schemes. This year, the authority recouped 6.2 million cedis from over 70% of employers who defaulted in the payment of employees' pension benefits. It is seeking legal action against 15 employers who have failed to pay. Apart from SNIT, it deals with 23 corporate trustees.
The first thing we had to do under the law was to license these corporate trustees, because for the first time, tier two and tier three were created in our pension structure, because it used to be only tier one, which was SNIT. So we had a mandate to license tier two and tier three operators, and these are the corporate trustees. And as part of our mandate, we have to ensure that we inspect their activities both on-site and off-site. So every month, they have to give us their operational report, their investment reports, you know. And every quarter, they have to put all these together and then provide them for us. Now that becomes the subject of our off-site inspection. Then on top of that, we actually go to the site to check the records that they have been providing for us in the off-site inspection to make sure that exactly they say what they say is what they're doing.
Trustees of these contributions also have their own concerns. These include porting of members, which is currently being put on hold by the regulator.
It's in the law that once you move from one trustee to the other, members should be able to port their contributions to their current trustees. But currently, the regulator has put a hold on porting, which is a challenge to us. They put a hold on porting because of what we call the suspense account. That is data which are not up to date. But we can say that some trustees are up to date with their data. Some also are not up to date. I wouldn't be able to tell for other trustees. So for those who are up to date with their suspense accounts, they cannot be mixed together with those who are not complying. So it really frustrates competition when it comes to sourcing for clientele.
The new National Pension Scheme, instituted by the National Pensions Act, Act 766, ensures that every Ghanaian worker receives retirement benefits when due. In 2020, however, the first batch of retirees from the Tier 2 and Tier 3 faced some challenges with their lump sum.
When the complaints started coming, we went around the country and solicited the views of our members. And really, we had those challenges coming up, that people were shortchanged, especially those who retired in 2020. Because, you know, this the three-tier pension began in 2010. But it payment effectively came on board in 2020.
Raise was last year. Right. And now we talked about the transfer of the TPFA. For 6 years, their contributions were in Bank of Ghana. It was attracting interest at TB rates, for example. And then after the transfer, it started attracting interest at government bond rates, which was a little bit higher. So the investment history was not very smooth because the schemes did not manage the funds right from the very beginning. So naturally, the first batch of retirees had a bit of a blip in terms of the returns, and the return rate was not as effective as it would have been if the money had been transferred from day one. So we've had situations where there are complaints that the lump sum that people received in 2020 were not as good as perhaps maybe they would have received under the PNDC Law 247 if it was still with SNIT. That is a matter which is being investigated. There's a committee that has been set up, and the government has given a commitment that in event of the committee producing this report and it is found out that there was any shortfall, the government is prepared to pay up the shortfall.
Labour consultant Ben Arthur says despite some challenges experienced in the pension scheme, it still remains paramount to the worker.
You don't just save only for pensions. You also make savings in such a way that when you become at any point in time unemployed, you can also fall on those savings, at least to fill in the gap until you get employed some other time. But workers, I don't know whether generally they take some of this education seriously.
For Thomas Ba, he still has regrets. He currently juggles working as an HR manager and as an employee with the Zongo Development Fund. With 8 years to retire, he says despite his pension contributions, he cannot overcome regrets of many years wasted in borrowing.
TAPRA just sent me my tier 2 money before February. That's 130 something cedis. You can save that one, having my 8 years left for me to go and retire. The right time I sat down and began to calculate, even recently, I took a loan from a bank, which I wouldn't like to mention their name here, 14,000. I end up paying 38,000. Now, looking at the excess money I paid, could that help me put up at least two rooms for myself? So my inability to save made me that at this my age, I have just some few years to go on retirement. I am now starting a building.
The whole concept of retirement has changed and people have not caught up with it. They don't realize that you need to have a plan for yourself that doesn't rely on family or friends for support, that doesn't even rely on SNIT. Like, what SNIT gives you should be a bonus. It shouldn't be, if your SNIT check doesn't come, then you're finished.
Ben Arthur implores employers to also verify with the National Pensions Regulatory Authority to ensure fund managers are licensed.
As soon as they take their salaries, they are not also interested in what is going into their pensions and the rest. So at the end of the day, you realize that it's not being paid. How many of us have made contributions to SNIT and have bothered to go to SNIT to find out the status of your contribution? Many people don't care. It is when they are getting very close to pension, that is when their antennas are waking and they want to know what is happening in the industry.
For example, some people will get, say, 1,500 as their monthly salary, but then they get 500 for their housing, 200 for their distance. So when you count that is around 1,000. But they are only paying SNIT on 1,500. Even though they are going home with 2,500. So when they go on pension, their pension will be determined using 1,500 as the maximum. And depending on the number of years they have worked, they may get a percentage of that 1,500. Already, because they were going home with 2,500, already they've lost about half of that. So this is the problem. So what both the employer and the worker should do is to consolidate all entitlements and place it on all of them.
The Trades Union Congress says some reforms in the new law is the only solution.
Really, I think reforms will be the best solution to this issue. And it is something that I think we have started and we will continue to agitate for that until the right payment is made to our members. It's a good thing for us to do. I mean, reviewing of the whole law, that is not beneficial to the Act 766 and 47. Another reform we want to say is that this new pension, the 766, was to make pensions, equal to everybody, to bring everybody on board. But here we are, some of the security and the rest are not part of the pension. It's also, we see that as it is not bringing the unity of purpose that the law or the new pensions wanted to address. It makes it undermining. So I think that it is time for all of us to come together to look at all this nitty-gritty of these issues and ensure that we have a better pension system in this country.
With a 5-year strategic plan spanning 2022 to 2026, the NPRA is focusing on increasing pensions coverage with a disciplined market.
We've grown the private sector pensions to 23 billion and the public sector pensions to 9 billion, almost 10 billion now. So by the end of the first quarter of 2021, pension funds in Ghana was 33.4 billion. Mm-hmm. You know, and if over a period of 10 years, an asset of an industry has grown that tremendously,
then you can imagine the next 10 years. So if you look at our strategic plan, we are saying as our focus that apart from the 40% penetration of the informal sector, we also want to grow pension funds to 50 billion by 2026. Now, if you have an industry that is growing so astronomically, then you begin to see that the potential for it to overtake all other, you know, areas of the economy are very, very high. Potentially, it is the biggest area that we all have to keep our eye on.
The NPRA is also looking forward to increasing coverage in the informal sector from the current 3% to 40% by 2026. For Thomas Barr, the 55-year-old counting down to retirement, he has this advice for all workers.
When you see the sun rise and sets, time has no limit. Time runs too fast and quick. And that is my personal advice to young nurses, young teachers, young guys, start saving now. And if you want, make sure if you start work before 8:25, target yourself by 8:35, your dream building, you should complete it. If you are 14, you don't start saving, then please, you are in trouble.
When you are there at the end of the month, they give you allowances, then you see that your salary is a bit at this thing, so you enjoy, but you forget that you come. So you must think about the contribution that you make, so that when you come on retirement, you won't come and suffer. Those who are working now, they must plan and see themselves as we pensioners. Take yourself that I'm a pensioner. What have I done? So that when I start my pension this thing, my problem that I will face or whatever, that's how your life will be. So you must plan well towards the pension.
Once you also decide to start saving for retirement, you need to choose wisely on how you want to invest money to secure your future.